Akbayan votes no for yet another extension of the factually and constitutionally impaired martial law in Mindanao, dealing a critical blow to Philippine democracy. This martial law extension will lead to a no-election scenario, as COMELEC can invoke, and in fact, it has invoked last September 6, that martial law can be a basis for the postponement of an electoral exercise. Now, we have made martial law some sort of the new normal, absent of any proof of actual invasion or rebellion, a condition required by our constitution. Martial law now desensitizes the people to wrongly equate it with good governance and democracy. Martial law now makes war as an instrument of national policy rather than the pursuit of peace, justice, equality, freedom through a negotiated peace settlement with those who rebel against government. President Duterte's war in Mindanao saw us spending 587.1 billion since martial law was declared 6 months ago. Another extension will bleed democracy and funds to fight poverty. And with the looming certainty of a charter change through a proposed constituent assembly, national elections can now be imperiled, can be postponed by passing a new transitory provision to declare the 2019 elections cancelled or postponed till 2022. Now with martial law that can possibly be implemented nationwide, I think this will deal a death blow to our democracy. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Thank you. Representative Ria Vergara is second.